Weeks? Mr. Weeks, open up.
He's not home.
I got this key from the neighbor.
Did the neighbor give you a warrant, too?
No, just this key.
Okay.
This is evidence.
It's very incriminating.
Let's use it.
Do we have a warrant?
No.
Okay.
Joe.
Look, it's Weeks.
I'll get him.
There's strong evidence here that you used the U.S. mail to transfer lottery tickets.
Where'd you get that?
Your house.
Did you have a warrant?
No. Just this key.
That's a violation of the Fourth Amendment.
You're right. By the exclusionary clause, your evidence must be thrown out.
The judge held that the warrantless searches and arrest of Weeks was a Fourth Amendment violation, and that the seizures and arrests were an invasion of Weeks' right of personal security, personal liberty, and private property. And thus, the exclusionary rule was born, allowing defendants to challenge the admissibility of evidence obtained without a warrant or other constitutional justification.
Gideon? Do I have a Clarence Gideon?
Someone's in my name?
Order, order. You're late, Mr. Gideon. Please sit down.
Like I haven't heard that 1,000 times before.
Mr. Gideon, we have evidence to suggest that you broke into the Bay Harbor pool room. You smashed the cigarette machine. You smashed the record player, and you stole money from the cash register. What do you have to say for yourself?
What do I have to say for myself? Your Honor, I plead the third, the fourth, and the fifth.
Mr. Gideon, where is your attorney? Is he also running late?
Your Honor, I'm a drifter. I can't afford a dentist appointment. You think I can afford an attorney?
Well, I hope you came prepared to serve as your own counsel today, Mr. Gideon.
Your Honor, I'd like a moment to confer with my client. After much deliberation, the defense has decided we're screwed.
And indeed he was screwed. Until then, states only needed to appoint counsel for those indigent criminals facing the death penalty. Gideon defended himself without the benefit of legal counsel. He was found guilty and sentenced to 5 years in prison. Gideon vs. Rainwright made an important contribution to the due process revolution going on in court. It was not long before all defendants that could not afford an attorney had the right to one appointed to them.
So, this is just the guy? Apparently he did some pretty shady abortion. Mr. Wolf? My first case.
Detective Scott? My chief partnered me with him about 4 months ago. He's a junior detective, but this is his first case as a lead detective. I'm a little worried about him.
Hello, Mr. Wolf? I don't think he's here. We just gonna have a look around.
Do we need a warrant?
He did what?
This is good.
Will the defendant please state his case?
Well, he didn't have a warrant, and he entered my house without my consent.
I didn't know I needed a warrant.
Wolf claimed that evidence obtained illegally should not have been used against him because it violated his constitutional rights. The evidence was still admitted, and Wolf was convicted despite the warrantless search and seizure. The decision in Wolf v. Colorado advised that states should exclude evidence from trial if it was illegally obtained, but left the ultimate decision for such exclusion in the hands of the state.
We know what you did. We know you took that woman out to the desert and you raped her.
What?
What country are you from?
What?
What ain't no country I ever heard of? They speak English in what?
What?
English, mother. Do you speak it?
Yes, yes.
So you understand what I am saying?
Yes, yes.
Did you rape that woman?
What?
Say what again? Say what one more time? I dare you. I double dare you, mother. Say what one more goddamn time? Did you rape that woman?
They don't tell me my rights, Holmes.
Is this not a common practice in your police department, Sheriff?
No, I guess not.
At no time was Miranda told of his right to counsel. Prior to being presented with the form at which he was already asked to write out the confession he had already given orally, he was not advised of his right to remain silent, nor was he informed that his statements during the interrogation would be used against him. Court-appointed lawyer Alvin Moore objected that because of these facts, the confession was not truly voluntary and should be excluded. At trial, the prosecution's case consisted solely of his confession. Miranda was convicted of both rape and kidnapping and sentenced to 20 to 30 years in prison. He appealed to the Arizona Supreme Court, claiming that the police had unconstitutionally obtained his confession. The court disagreed, however, and upheld the conviction. Miranda appealed to the U.S. Supreme Court, which reviewed the case in 1966. The Supreme Court, in a 5-4 decision, ruled that the prosecution could not introduce Miranda's confession as evidence in a criminal trial because the police had failed to first inform Miranda of his right to an attorney and against self-incrimination. The police duty to give these warnings is compelled by the Constitution's Fifth Amendment, which gives a criminal suspect the right to refuse to be witness against himself, and Sixth Amendment, which guarantees criminal defendants the right to an attorney. To protect these rights in the face of widespread ignorance of the law, court devised statements that the police are required to tell a defendant who is being detained and interrogated. These became known as the Miranda rights.
Donahue, this woman is dangerous. If she's connected to this bombing, we have to be careful, okay?
I got it, Polanski. I can handle it.
Use the force. Miss Map, open up.
Miss Map, open the door.
We have some questions. It's the police.
It's about a recent bombing.
I need to get my lawyer on the phone. Hello? The police are outside. What do I do?
She's not open up, dude.
We gotta break in.
Do we have a warrant?
Donahue, this isn't one of those cop TV shows. This is the real deal. We're real cops.
Let's get in.
This is about justice. We're breaking in. Miss Mack, there's no arguing here!
Judge.
Sorry. Guilty.
No! I want to appeal to the Supreme Court!
Miss Mack, the evidence remains irrefutable. You were clearly involved in this bombing.
No, this is against my constitutional right. They came to my house without a warrant, I had my lawyer on the phone, and they barged in and arrested me.
She's right. That's against the Fourth Amendment.
aftermath, state police as well as state courts, where most criminal prosecutions take place, were obliged to follow the Fourth Amendment prohibition against illegal search and seizure.
I have one more question.
What?
Are you the map?
I don't know what you're talking about.
It's a simple question. Are you or are you not the map?
What are you talking about?
Woman! Damn it! Are you the map? I'm asking you, are you the f***ing map?
I am the map.
If there's a place you gotta go, I'm the one you need to know. I'm the map. I'm the map, I'm the map. If there's a place you gotta get, I can get you there, I bet. I'm the map. I'm the map, I'm the map, I'm the map.